Welcome everyone, I'm Wilfred G. Pasamba, and I'm presenting my project called wingpforms. This is a project in web information systems. I have done plenty of web information systems, hundreds, and this is the motivation for making this one is just that when you have made too many retrieve applications on the web, you start to think of ways to enable other people to create those kinds of applications without the need of code. And a recent lingering request here around my area is like they need a form, an app for this one, an app for this one, an app for this one, and actually there are existing paper forms. But I think there's a way for secretaries or departments or non-programmers to create web applications without the knowledge of programming. That is to enable them to create forms instead of like the forms in Word or in Excel. They create web forms by themselves and put people there to approve the forms, put text, put signature boxes, and then they can tag people, and then people can instantiate a fill-up of a form, and that would be an instance of a form, and people can put their names, and those who are supposed to sign can just approve or comment on this, and like the forms will be online, will be approved, and will be static there. They can retrieve it, they can see the history of comments or reviews, and so on, of the approvals or disapprovals. And instead of walking the paper form going around the organization, it will be an online form, which anyone can create, anyone can, or just the time people can approve. You're supposed to get notifications if somebody comments on your form, the form can be public or private. So it's like a big system, but the idea is to enable people or normal users to create. I know it's above, like, not the normal application where you create, retrieve, edit, delete, update, those applications, but this one is a customer board of actually doing those things. Anyway, as you see in the screen, I have two cameras, one to see typing and one for my icon, and I was recording in OBS so that you can see. So let me log out. It is part of a big system called IOLIS, AUP Online Information Systems, and I have many web applications here already, and this I was just motivated to do this in class to just create another one which will supposed to try to end all of this proliferation of applications, but instead let people make their own forms and let the forms take over the applications. Hopefully, just a dream. Anyway, let me try. I finished. This is the login. It resides on the first before letting you log in. I log in with my own account. And you see in the first screen a list of forms that were created. Since we tested this, I tested this. This form was created by me. As you see, edit. I have a log of activities for that form. And as you see here, there is no delete, but there's an expire. The expire just hides. I'm not fond of deletes because people have to take responsibility over what they do, but I hide things that are not supposed to be shown. And when I expire, I don't show it there, but I can still see it in the database, if need be, so that the history will not go away. So I can expire this, I can edit, and you can create a new form. The reason I put the create new form down is so that people can still, people tend to like to create new forms, but I put it always down, so there's a tendency to edit the things first before creating, because people sometimes duplicate things. So I always put the create form at the bottom, and each of these forms can be edited like this. I realize this is like Google Forms, but Google Forms doesn't have native notifications and native approvals. You have to add a module. So I'm looking at the edit. This is how the edit forms looks like. You can put signature boxes, date. So there's a text box, there's a text area, there's a signature box. This first phase of this whole system, the form system, is just the editing of the forms. So I did not yet do, I transferred the notifications and the messages to the other phase of this project, which is not covered in this project because it's too big. Anyway, I hope this is enough to give confidence to this class that I actually learned something in this class and that I'm actually sharing something in this class. We are going to making the applications. Okay, you can add a text. You can add, this is how a text looks like. Now there's an example here. You can add a one-line input box. This is the text box. In HTML, it's an input. And there's also a add multi-line. This one is multi-line input box. A signature prompt. This is a signature prompt. And you can view form without editing clicks. That's how it looks like. It's a simple. It's not as complicated as the one in the paper, but it's like Google Forms. You can have everything in Google Forms, but you can do many things in Google Forms. And you can, of course, sort them up. It's a simple sorting. If I want the name down, okay, see, it went down. Name went down. Down. So in the next version, you will be able to drag and drop those things. But this is the first iteration. I just want to make it work. Of course, there's a view. This is how the view form. And that's it. I tried to get some computer science people to experiment with this, those people who actually do the forms themselves, and they created different kinds of forms: defense form, laptop request form, promissory note for the finance form, git pass form, parents consent form, book request form, print in form, and the transcript of record form. So thank you for watching. I'm Wilfred Pasamba. I'm trying to create an application that will enable many people to create their own web applications with notifications and signatures and comments on forms. It's like making forms online. Hope you get this idea, and it's exciting. Bye bye. Okay, we're going to create a form. Create new form. We'll name the form appointment slip. Appointment slip. Okay, submit, so there it is. And then we can edit it, of course, if I want it to slip. Appointment slip version 1. Appointment slip version 1.0. Edit works. And then let's add text. Let's say, Adventist University. Okay, it's here. Let's add the one line input box. What? Another input box, when? Another input box, time? Another input box, venue? Then agenda. Probably the agenda will be multi-line. Okay, so if I want to edit something, I can just edit, remove the space, add the space, submit. So for example, agendas is the simplest thing. Or maybe agenda should be really just agenda. So that's how it is. I can remove it if I want to. I can move the venue. It disappears. I can put it back, so I just re-add the venue. And then I can just make it go up so that it looks exactly like this form. Agenda, and then we have the thank you. Let's add text, thank you. And then let's add a signature prompt, sender. Okay, so I made a generic appointment slip, and let's view it. This is how it looks like. And now people can just instantiate this kind of slip, put information, tag people, and put their name here so they get the notifications, and there was a tag people there. So that's how it is. Add, edit, view of these forms. Thank you.